In this example, we will create a user form that utilizes option buttons and a combo box. The option button and combo box controls are used when we want the user to make a single selection from a list of options. We will create a user form that tells the user the cost of a shirt based on the shirt brand and the shirt size. There will be 3 brands and 5 sizes to choose from. The user will choose a shirt brand using an option button control and the shirt size using a combo box control. First, we create a new user form. The name of the user form will be shirt price. And the caption will be shirt price calculator. Next, we add an option button control to the user form. The name of the option button will be Option Brand X. And the caption will be Brand X. We also could have changed the caption on this option button by clicking on it directly. We'll change the font size. And we can add 2 more option buttons for the other 2 brands of shirts by copying and pasting the first option button. For the second option button, I'll change the caption to Brand Y and the name to Option Brand Y. For the third option button, I'll change the caption to Brand Z and the name to Option Brand Z. At this point, if we want to move the option buttons to a new location, we'd have to move them manually one by one. We also could insert a frame control into the user form and drag all the option buttons into the frame. Now, if I wish to move all the option buttons to a new location, I can simply just move the frame. I will change the frame caption to shirt brand, and I will increase the font size. For the shirt sizes, we'll use a combo box. Click on the combo box control. And drag out a combo box on the user form. We'll change the name of the combo box to CBO shirt size. Under the text property, we'll type size and change the font to a larger size. And finally, we'll need a text box that will display the cost of a shirt. We'll change the name of this text box to Total Cost. And let's add a label that will let the user know that this box contains the total cost. Although we've created a combo box, we still need to give the user options for different shirt sizes. So we click anywhere on the user form, and we add the following code. This sub-procedure that I've just inserted is activated every time the drop-down button on the combo box named CBO Shirt Size is clicked. Inside the sub-procedure, we use the built-in function named array to populate the list of options for the user. In this case, we are going to have 5 options: extra small, small, medium, large, and extra large. For user forms that require input from more than one control to calculate the quantity of interest, which is the cost of the shirt in this case, it is often convenient to make public variables that are accessible to all procedures used by the user form. So double-click again on the user form, and just after option explicit and before our first sub-procedure, we are going to create 3 public variables. The public variable brand cost will store the cost of the shirt due to the brand name. Size cost will store the cost of the shirt due to the size, and tote cost stores the total cost of the shirt. We want the cost of the shirt to be updated as soon as the user selects a shirt size. We go to the sub-procedure CBO shirt size change, which was created when we double-clicked on the combo box named CBO shirt size, and we will insert some code. We obtain the text that is stored in the combo box named CBO shirt size. This is the shirt size that has been selected by the user. We will compare this value against all the different sizes. If the user selected XS, the cost due to the size of the shirt will be 0. If the user has selected S, size cost will be 2. If the user selects M, size cost will be 4. If the user selects L, size cost will be 5. If the user selects XL, size cost will be 6. Tote cost, which is the total cost of the shirt, will be updated based on what the user has selected for size cost. And this new value will be displayed in the text box named Total Cost. Every time the user changes the shirt size, this sub-procedure will be executed. Next, we'll need our code to recalculate the cost of the shirt based on the brand of the shirt selected. So going back to the user form, we'll double-click on the 3 option buttons and 3 blank sub-procedures will be created. The sub-procedure option brand X click will be executed every time the user clicks on the option button named option brand X. The sub-procedure option brand Y click will be executed every time the user selects the option button named option brand Y. And the sub-procedure option brand Z click will be executed every time the user selects the option button named option brand Z. I've added some code that will recalculate the cost of the shirt based on the brand selected by the user. If the user selects brand X, brand cost will be 25, tote cost will be updated and this value will be displayed in the text box named total cost. If brand Y is selected, brand cost will become 35, tote cost will be updated and this new value will be displayed in the text box named total cost. If brand Z is selected, brand cost is 65 and the updated value of tote cost will be displayed in the text box named total cost. Notice that by using public variables, we do not have to worry about passing the values of size cost, brand cost, and tote cost to the various sub-procedures. Each sub-procedure used by the user form knows the value of all three variables at all times. Going back to the user form, I will change the font size in the text box so that way the user can easily see the total cost of the shirt. Now our user form is ready. Let's insert a module and create a macro that will bring the user form named shirt price into existence. ShirtPrice.show will load the user form named ShirtPrice. If we run the macro named Shirts, a user form will appear. And notice that the cost of the shirt changes instantly every time we make a change to the brand or size.